looking magnificent. Gabby Nigel, it is perfect weather, really. A little bit warm, but a crowd has gathered here. You can tell people still love the Biltmore House. They still love what George Vanderbilt envisioned before the turn of the century, the turn of the 20th century. The largest private home in America, 250 rooms. They measure it, Carol, by the acre under there. It's four acres under the roof.
Isn't that unbelievable?
It's astounding.
I don't know if you can see behind us, but there is some work going on the roof, and
right.
We were just talking about
yeah.
that. There is usually some sort of repair work going on, and the roof is special. Each one of those shingles has to be specially wired into the base of the roof. So there is work going on, as always, in a house this size, which is, of course, the biggest private residence in the United States. And, Michael, one of the things is that children do get in here for free during the summer.
And this time of year.
Families take advantage of it. And it's a great place for kids to roam. And one of the places they roam in is the summer garden.
They sure do. The summer garden is also the spring garden. If you come here during the spring, you get to see the tulips in full bloom. But you don't have to worry if the tulips aren't in bloom, which they are not now. Look at this, Carol. It's hard for me to say anything that tops the picture here. It's just full bloom all the time
yeah,
here in the summer garden.
And if you're a gardener, you'll recognize begonias, peppers, sages, coneflowers, butterfly bush, daylilies, dahlias, vitex, which I think is a ground cover. I'm sure one of the gardeners out there will correct me, but it's a beautiful place. And it is very close to another beautiful garden that's often not seen here at the Biltmore because it is sort of sunken
from
the road. And it's the Italian garden.
Just above the solarium there. You know, Frederick Law Olmsted, who designed a little place, by the way, he was the landscape architect on Central Park in New York City. He designed this. Look at this. This is the Italian garden right here.
And this is one of the places in the estate that is exactly the way it was when it was designed. Three pools, water lilies, hardy and tropical. Those flowers open in the evening and they stay blooming until the middle of the day. The tropicals do, and they're white, pink, blue. There are some exotic plants in here, even papyrus.
Papyrus, they grow rice in there as well. You know, Mr. Vanderbilt envisioned this as a self-sustaining property, 125,000 acres initially, 8,000 acres now. Absolutely beautiful.
And I hope you got to see the Victoria water platters. They're lily pads the
Massive.
Size of garbage can covers.